Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. Today I will discuss about Kenny-Caffey Syndrome, that is KCS. Kenny-Caffey Syndrome was first reported by two different groups of researchers in the 1960s. Kenny-Caffey Syndrome was initially described by a Canadian pediatrician named Francis M. Kenny in 1966. Kenny documented a group of children who exhibited a combination of growth retardation, cortical thickening of long bones, medullary stenosis, and characteristic facial features. The following year, in 1967, Dr. John Caffey, an American radiologist, independently reported similar findings in a group of patients. Caffey's work focused more on the radiological aspects of the condition, particularly the unique bone changes. Because the two researchers described similar condition around the same time, the syndrome was named Kenny-Caffey syndrome to acknowledge both contributors. Over time, the term has been used to describe two types of syndrome: Kenny-Caffey syndrome type 1, which is inherited in an autosomal recessive manner, and Kenny-Caffey syndrome type 2, which is inherited in an autosomal dominant manner. Each type has distinct genetic causes but share some clinical characteristics. Kenny-Caffey syndrome is a rare genetic disorder characterized by a combination of growth and skeletal abnormalities, as well as other systemic features. The syndrome is typically classified into two types based on its genetic inheritance pattern. Common symptoms of Kenny-Caffey syndrome are prominent forehead, flat nasal bridge, thickening of the outer layer of the long bones, medullary stenosis, increased bone density, skeletal dysplasia, vision impairment, hearing loss, etc. Affected individuals often have short stature and experience delayed growth compared to their peers. Motor and cognitive development may be delayed in affected individuals. KCS programs have low level of parathyroid hormone, which can lead to low blood calcium level, that is hypocalcemia. Hypocalcemia causes muscle cramps, tetany, that is muscle swells, and other signs related to low calcium. Additional symptoms which are less common and not present in all KCS cases include problems with teeth development or structure. In some cases, skin abnormalities or other dermatological issues may also be noted. Kenny-Caffey syndrome is an extremely rare genetic disorder, and its exact prevalence is not well documented due to its rarity, and the number of reported cases in medical literature is limited. Fewer than 200 cases have been documented globally. Due to its rarity and the overlap of its symptoms with other conditions, KCS may be underdiagnosed or misdiagnosed. Mutation in the tubulin folded cofactor E, that is TBCE gene, are associated with KCS1. TBCE gene is located on chromosome 1 at Q42.3 position. It spans approximately 81.9 kilobases and consists of 18 exons. The TBCE gene is involved in the assembly and maintenance of microtubules, which are essential for various cellular functions. Mutations in the family with sequence similarity 111 member A gene are associated with KCS2 type. The FAM111A gene is located on long arm of chromosome 11 at Q12.1 position, composed of 5 exons, but only 2 of these exons, that is exons 3 and 4, encode the 70 kilodaltons FAM protein. The FAM-111A gene is involved in cell cycle regulation and DNA repair. The diagnosis of KCS is based on clinical evaluation, radiographic findings, and genetic testing. The presence of characteristic skeletal abnormalities and other symptoms combined with genetic testing for mutations in the TBCE or FAM-111A gene can confirm the diagnosis. There is no cure for Kenny-Caffey syndrome because it is a genetic disorder and its gene therapy is not reported so far. Early diagnosis and multidisciplinary care can help manage symptoms and improve quality of life for individuals with Kenny-Caffey syndrome. Treatment focuses on managing symptoms and preventing complications. This may include regular assessment of growth and development and monitoring and managing bone density, including possible interventions to address skeletal abnormalities. Treatment for hypoparathyroidism and hypocalcemia, including calcium and vitamin D supplementation, reduce metabolic symptoms. Early intervention and supportive therapies for developmental delays as well as management of vision or hearing impairment, if present, improve the symptoms. This is all about Kenny-Caffey syndrome. Today, we learned about Kenny-Caffey syndrome, its causes, symptoms, and how it affects the body. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with your friends and family members to spread awareness. If you have any query or questions, drop comment in comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of yourself. Thank you very much.